So we have already completed the first chapter, that is money and banking. And today we are starting the public finance. So what is the meaning of public finance? Public finance deals with all the transactions of the government, right? Sorry, this period is wrong. This is not, this is basically we can say from June 20 till April 21. So please solve this question and give the answer to me in the chat box. Okay, so everyone is giving the answer C. And answer is C only. You are correct. We will discuss how. Second question is the previous year question. Right, so answer to this question is D. Again, we will come. So let's discuss the government budget, components of the government budget. The budget is basically a kind of account where we record all the transactions of the government that we are expecting to happen in the future. So that's the kind of estimation. Budget is futuristic. So when we introduce the budget in the month of February 21, we introduce the budget for the next 1 year. Budget is always futuristic. It is estimated. It is not actual, right? So when we are expecting certain amount on under different head, we divide the transactions into two categories. One is the receipt, another is the payment. Okay. So just assume that you are a student and you have all your own budget for the next month. For the month of September 2021. So for September 2021, you will list down what amount of receipt you are going to make and what amount of expenditure you are going to make in the month of September 2021, right? So first is the receipt. Now we are talking about the central government. Okay, here budget is about the government. And when I say government, it is basically central government, not any other kind of government. The central government, what are the sources of receipt for the central government? It has two types of receipt. One is the capital receipt, another is the revenue receipt. Capital receipt is a receipt which has an impact over the asset or liability. Impact over the asset or liability. So either it will lead to increase in the asset. Sorry, it will reduce the asset or it will increase the liability. Okay. Revenue receipt is something which is not having any impact on the asset and liability. And so this is the primary difference. Now, revenue receipt can further be categorized into two categories. The revenue coming from the tax, that is called tax revenue. The revenue coming from the non-tax, that is called non-tax revenue. So tax can further be divided into direct and indirect. Direct is something which is impacting the same person who is paying that tax. Suppose I pay the income tax. So I have to pay the income tax from my own pocket. I cannot charge from my students. But if I have to pay the GST, goods and services tax, or earlier it used to be sales tax, or now it is an excise duty on the petroleum, then I have to pay this tax from my pocket. So payment will be done from my pocket, but I will shift the burden to my students, to my customers, right? So indirect tax is something which I am actually making the payment, but the burden is shifted upon the third person, right? So direct tax can be in income tax, corporate tax. Income tax and corporate tax are same in the sense that both are basically income tax only. Income tax, we call it when this tax is on the income of a person. So this is a personal income tax. A corporate tax is basically the income tax on a company's income. Then we have other taxes, wealth tax, gift tax, estate duty, and expenditure tax. Indirect taxes may we have GST primarily nowadays. GST was introduced in 2017. And still we have sales tax, custom duty, excise duty, service tax. Like, not everything is covered by the GST. Most of the things are covered by GST, but not everything as of now. Okay. Non-tax revenue. Now, what other kind of receipt can be? Interest. So government pays, give some loan to the state government. Central government gives a loan to the state government. So it will receive the interest from the state government. Profits. So central government has a ownership of the companies like LIC, or it has profit from, for example, railway. And dividend. Dividend is basically when government is having a ownership of a company less than 100%. So what is the difference between the profit and dividend? Profit means when the government is getting the profit from a corporation which is having 100% ownership by the central government, and dividend will be from that company where central government is having less than 100% ownership. For example, we have so many public sector undertaking like NTPC, ONGC, and like that. Fees, like government charges fees for many things. Fines, you have to pay the fines at many places, like external grants. Now, external grants is basically, suppose we get a grant from Japan or USA for a particular purpose. Suppose in the COVID time, we get a grant from some country. So that will be part of the revenue receipt. Please understand, if we get a loan from any other country, it is part of the capital receipt. That will become part of the capital receipt. That will become part of the borrowing, right? Borrowing ka part ban jayega. But if we get a grant, grant is basically, we don't have to return it back. That means it is not impacting the asset or liability. It is an income. So it will not be returned back. So it is part of the non-tax revenue. In case of special assessment tax, these are the taxes which are levied when someone is, hiding the tax and all. Coming to the capital receipts means those receipts which are impacting the asset or liability. Either when we receive the amount, cash amount receive hoga, either we are selling something, like we have an investment and we are selling that investment, which is the practice that government is doing nowadays. It can include disinvestment, that sale of shares in the other companies. Nowadays, government is also doing one thing very aggressively, that is asset monetization. So it is selling the asset of government or PSUs, which are lying unutilized and which have good amount of money, which can be earned by the government. Okay. So sale of shares, say asset monetization, say, yeah, government ne jo state government ko loan diye the, wahan se recovery ho gayi. These are the things which will actually decrease the asset. Isse kya hoga? Asset ko decrease hoga. Right. So transaction number first, second, and fifth, they are reducing the asset. जो हमारी एसेट्स थी उसको कम कर दिया. ट्रांजेक्शन नंबर थर्ड एंड फोर्थ, Sorry, guys, there was an urgent call. Okay. So, capital asset can be in the form of borrowing. That borrowing can be from, like, it can be from any public by issue of bond, or it can be from a global agency like IMF, World Bank, or it can be from any multilateral grouping like Asian Development Bank, BRICS Bank, like that. In the borrowing, again, there are two components. So please understand it very carefully. In the borrowing, basically, suppose you take your own example. Like when you have a need of 50,000 rupees, to suppose you have two choices. Either you can go to someone and you can request them that please give me 50,000 rupees, or luckily what happened, your friend come to you and he says, I have extra money and please keep this money with yourself for 6 months. I will need this money after 6 months. You are my trusted friend and I will take this money after 6 months from you. Okay. So this friend who came to you, he gives suppose 10,000 rupees to you. So now your total requirement was 50,000. Now how much you will borrow from the market? How much you will request from another person? You will request 40,000. Are you getting everyone what I'm trying to say? Please say yes, no. So borrowing can be of two type. One, someone is coming to you and depositing her extra money, or it can be that you are going to outside and you are requesting for the money. You are taking the loan from the outside. Are you getting my friends? Please say yes or no. Okay, very good. Now, how it works in the context of government? Let us see. So this 40,000 rupees, this is called actually the loan. And this 10,000 rupees, this is called NSSF. What is the full form of NSSF? Anyone? NSSF full form is National Small Saving Fund. So what is happening is public is coming to the government. General public is coming to the government and saying, ki sir, hamare 10,000 rupees extra hain. Aap saving ke liye rakh lijiye. Whenever in the future we need this money, we will take back from you. So this is 10,000 rupees is the public money, right? So this is what I mean by NSSF. Ki extra money jo public ki hai, wo government ke paas aayi. But government ke liye ye, this is actually a kind of borrowing only. It is not a market borrowing. It is not a market borrowing. This loan taken is a market borrowing. Normally borrowing, when we say borrowing, it is basically fiscal deficit. Kitna paisa hamare paas shortfall raha, right? So fiscal deficit has two components. One is the market borrowing and second is the NSSF. Okay. Now please tell me, if suppose fiscal deficit is 50,000 this year, NSSF is 10,000. So net market borrowing will be 40,000. Now we reverse the situation. We change the situation a bit. Suppose I say, Suppose I say that NSSF is now 20,000 this year, then borrowing will be less because fiscal deficit is same. So for any given level of fiscal deficit, if there is an increase in the NSSF, then market borrowing will come down. पहले हमें 40,000 मार्केट से जरूरत पड़ी थी, अभी हम 30,000 में काम हो जाएगा हमारा, क्योंकि टोटल तो हमें 50,000 ही चाहिए. आर यू गेटिंग माय फ्रेंड्स? डिड यू गेट दिस पॉइंट? लाइक दिस पॉइंट वाज एक्चुअली हाइलाइटेड इन वन ऑफ द इकोनॉमिक सर्वे 2017-18 इकोनॉमिक सर्वे 2017-18 का जो इकोनॉमिक सर्वे आया था वहां पर ये पॉइंट हाईलाइट हुआ था. ओके, दैट इज व्हाई आई एम डिस्कसिंग दिस. Okay, now this is the diagram from budget 21-22. Here you can see the receipts, the tax receipts as a percentage of GDP, and you can see gross tax receipts. So here you have to focus on the trend. Ki trend kya hai? Don't remember ki kitna percentage tha, but remember the trend. So trend is like here it is going upward, then it is coming down, then it is going upward, then down, then down. Then it is stable. So they will ask the question ki last 10 years mein increase ho raha tha ya nahi ho raha tha. So answer is it was not steadily increasing. Steadily ka matlab hota hai ki pahad ki tarah ekdam chalta chala ja raha hai, uncha hota chala ja raha hai. Theek hai, steadily agar hota to ye down nahi aata yahan pe. Theek hai, so steadily increase nahi ho raha hai. Okay, direct tax agar hum dekhe before 16-17, direct tax used to be more than before 15-16, it used to be more than indirect tax. In 1 year, 15-16 to 16-17, it was very close, and again it became more, and now you can see direct tax is less than the indirect tax. So tell me, is it a good thing or is it a bad thing? Direct tax less than indirect tax, is it desirable or not? Okay, so it is a subjective question. It is desirable because direct tax is progressive. Direct tax is progressive. Okay, so if direct tax is reduced, then indirect tax will increase, and indirect tax is not progressive. So direct tax in decreasing is not a good thing. Direct tax kam hota hai, so it is not desirable in this manner. Okay, because direct tax jo hai progressive hai. Progressive ka matlab jaise jaise income badhegi waise waise direct tax zyada lagta hai. Aur agar overall collection mein direct tax se kam ho raha hai, iska matlab kahin na kahin हमारा जो टैक्स कलेक्शन है वो प्रोग्रेसिव नहीं हो रहा है. जो इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स है वो प्रोग्रेसिव नहीं है. इनडायरेक्ट टैक्स इज नॉट प्रोग्रेसिव. ओके, सो इन दिस मैनर दिस डायरेक्ट टैक्स इज नॉट गुड. ओके, नाउ यू कैन सी द एग्जांपल इज बेस्ट एग्जांपल इज नाउअडेज यू कैन सी यू नो पेट्रोलियम प्राइसेस आर गोइंग अप. पेट्रोलियम प्राइसेस आर गोइंग अप, डीजल, पेट्रोल. सो ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है? बिकॉज लास्ट ईयर, इन द लास्ट वन ईयर देयर हैज बीन डिक्लाइन इन द इनकम टैक्स. The companies were not running properly. They did not earn enough. Individuals, they were not getting salaries. They did not earn enough. That is why income tax came down. And to compensate that loss, the government has actually increased the indirect tax. So that increase in the indirect tax in the form of petrol or diesel prices is actually adversely impacting the economy. Because increase in the petrol and diesel prices impacts everyone. Because it is the base of the transportation cost. It actually impacts the transportation cost. So if transportation cost increases, everyone is impacted. Even a rickshaw puller will be impacted, because the vegetables, the salt, the basic thing that he or she will be eating will be having a higher cost because of the increase in the petroleum, the fuel cost of the transportation. Okay, so direct tax being less than indirect tax is not a desirable situation, right? Now coming to the expenditure part. So one thing is revenue and capital receipt. Another is revenue and the capital expenditure. ठीक है, तो expenditure के अंदर भी क्या होगा? The items which are impacting the asset or liability, they are part of the capital expenditure, and otherwise it is the revenue expenditure. So capital expenditure में you can say construction कर रहे हैं हम लोग, land and machinery खरीद रहे हैं, shares खरीद रहे हैं, या लैंड एंड मशीनरी हम खरीद रहे हैं, शेयर्स हम खरीद रहे हैं, तो बेसिकली व्हाट वी आर डूइंग, वी आर इंक्रीजिंग द एसेट. इन लोन टू एस्टेट दे रहे हैं, ये भी क्या होगा, इंक्रीज इन द एसेट. एंड व्हेन वी आर रीपेइंग द लोन, वी आर डिक्रीजिंग द लायबिलिटी. सो आइदर वी आर इंक्रीजिंग द एसेट और वी आर डिक्रीजिंग द लायबिलिटी. दिस इज कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर. अदर एक्सपेंडिचर्स आर रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर. ओके, सो इंटरेस्ट पेमेंट करना, सैलरी पेमेंट करना, ग्रांट्स, सब्सिडीज, एजुकेशन, हेल्थ, डिफेंस, इवन डिफेंस इज पार्ट ऑफ द रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर. ओके, नाउ प्लीज कीप इन माइंड, ग्रांट इज अ रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर, इट इज नॉट अ कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर, राइट? बिकॉज वी डोंट हैव एनी एसेट क्रिएटेड बिकॉज ऑफ द ग्रांट, राइट? सो यू कैन सी द बजट 21-22 फिगर्स हियर for various items. No need to remember all of this, just look into it at a glance. Resources transferred to the state and duties, these have been increasing over the past period because of the GST commitments and because of the 14th Finance Commission recommendations. Okay, central revenue and expenditure. Now you can see this is revenue. रुपी कम्स फ्रॉम, कहां से पैसा आता है? सबसे ज्यादा पैसा आता है हमारा बोरोइंग से, बोरोइंग एंड अदर लायबिलिटीज. बोरोइंग हमने देखा, मार्केट बोरोइंग, अदर लायबिलिटीज मींस एनएसएसएफ. सबसे ज्यादा हमें लोन उठाना पड़ता है, 36%, इज वेरी गुड अमाउंट, वेरी बिग अमाउंट एक्चुअली. कॉर्पोरेशन टैक्स, इनकम टैक्स 13+14 27 हो गया, जीएसटी 15, देन अदर्स आर लेस. ठीक है, तो हाइएस्ट पैसा कहां से आता है? borrowing and other liabilities से, और second highest आपका आता है income tax and corporate tax से, और third आता आपका है GST से. So they can ask a question कि इसको जो है आप series में arrange कीजिए, so you can remember about this. Coming to the expenditure part, highest expenditure is going in the form of state share of the taxes and duties, जो shareable taxes होते हैं. It is not the highest. Highest is this one, interest payment. इंटरेस्ट पेमेंट हाईएस्ट है इसमें. आप समझ लीजिए, जितना भी गवर्नमेंट के पास में रेवेन्यू आता है उसका 20 रुपए तो आपको इंटरेस्ट के रूप में चला जाता है, जो कि एक तरह से डेड कॉस्ट है, विच इज नॉट क्रिएटिंग एनीथिंग, राइट? सब्सिडीज आर ऑलमोस्ट 9%, विच इज अगेन ए वेरी बिग अमाउंट, वेरी वेरी बिग अमाउंट. ओके, नंबर्स हियर यू कैन सी, रेवेन्यू रिसीट प्लस कैपिटल रिसीट मींस टोटल रिसीट, and then total expenditure. Based upon this, we calculate fiscal deficit. The difference between the total receipt and total expenditure is fiscal deficit. Out of the fiscal deficit, we also bring revenue deficit separately and effective revenue deficit and primary deficit. We will see what is the meaning of this. Okay, so you know what is the difference between fiscal deficit, revenue deficit, effective revenue deficit, and primary deficit. Sorry, I write primary deficit here. After fiscal deficit, I write primary deficit anyways. The fiscal deficit, primary deficit, revenue deficit, and effective revenue deficit. What is the difference? Can anyone tell? You can unmute yourself and you can speak out.
So fiscal deficit is total expenditure have to be minus total receipts, excluding the borrowings, except the borrowing. Sir, I'm audible?
Okay, basically, what is the meaning of deficit? Deficit is basically shortfall. Like, suppose you take your own example. In 1 month, you get 10,000 rupees from your father, and your expenditure is 15,000. So 5,000 is the deficit. That is a shortfall in the revenue that you have in your pocket. So that is called deficit. Similarly, with the government also, the difference between the total receipt and the expenditure is called deficit. Okay, total receipt and the expenditure. Now, fiscal deficit is basically the total amount of borrowing and other liability. Because the difference between the total receipts and the liability will be this borrowing only. Jitna paisa hume short pada, utna humne borrowing ya other liabilities se arrange kar liya. So that is fiscal deficit. What is primary deficit? Primary deficit is when we reduce the interest payment from the fiscal deficit. Fiscal deficit minus interest payment. Because interest payment is basically for the past years. We cannot judge the performance of the current government based upon the interest payment. Hai na? So why we are calculating fiscal deficit? To judge the performance of the current government. But in the fiscal deficit, jo short hamara hua, usme hamara interest payment bhi included hai, jo humne kiya hai. Aur interest payment kiske liye hai? Jo past mein humne kabhi borrowing ki thi, wo bhi previous government ne borrowing ki thi, not this government, right? Just give me a second. Yeah, so we will reduce that amount which was paid as an interest, because the interest belongs to the loan which was taken by the previous government, right? The current government is just paying the interest. It has nothing to do with why the previous government took the loan. So primary deficit is a better indicator of the performance of the present government. Okay. Third is revenue deficit. Revenue deficit is basically shortfall in the revenue. So revenue deficit is a very bad thing, because revenue deficit is something ki hamari income to 10 rupees hai, lekin hum kharch kar rahe hain 12 rupees. Theek hai? Hamari income 10 rupees, hum kharch kar rahe hain 12 rupees. Revenue means hum day-to-day expenses ke liye. Day-to-day एक्सपेंसेस के लिए हम खर्च कर रहे हैं. हम कुछ बिल्ड नहीं कर रहे हैं, हम कुछ एसेट क्रिएट नहीं कर रहे हैं, हम डे टू डे एक्सपेंडिचर के लिए पेमेंट कर रहे हैं, तो हमारा रेवेन्यू डेफिसिट हो रहा है. इफेक्टिव रेवेन्यू डेफिसिट इज बेसिकली रेवेन्यू डेफिसिट माइनस द अमाउंट गिवन एज ए ग्रांट टू द स्टेट फॉर क्रिएशन ऑफ द एसेट. सपोज सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट गिव्स 50,000 रुपीज ऑफ ग्रांट टू द हरियाणा गवर्नमेंट, एंड हरियाणा गवर्नमेंट इज एक्चुअली एस्टैब्लिशिंग ए power plant using that 50,000 rupees. Now that power plant is a asset, but for the central government, because it is a grant, so grant cannot be the capital expenditure, so it is revenue expenditure. So technically, in the form, in the formal manner, it is basically a capital, it is a revenue expenditure. But if we see at a macro level, this revenue expenditure is creating an asset for the state government. So this is actually a capital expenditure if we see at a broad level. So we will reduce this kind of expenditure from the revenue deficit so that we can get a effective figure, we can get a correct picture of the situation. So effective revenue deficit is better than the revenue deficit. Did you get these two concepts? ERD and PD? Everyone? Please say yes, no. Okay. So answer is C here. We have already seen. Answer is D here. Already discussed. Now please answer this question. Okay, Prakash, so answering to your question, normally the fiscal deficit that we read in day to day, that is net fiscal deficit. So, jo hum baat karte hain fiscal deficit ki, this is actually net fiscal deficit. So, what is gross fiscal deficit? Gross fiscal deficit is basically when we do not exclude. When we do not adjust repayment of the debt. Repayment of debt ko hum exclude nahi karte hain. Right. So if we are borrowing some money for repayment of the debt, that is actually not because of the current year fault. Hai na? So repayment is basically for the past year. Repayment is for the past year. So when we are considering, when we are not adjusting this, then it is repayment of the debt. So this is gross fiscal deficit. Okay. So now this question, please see. I have already discussed this question in the form of example that I gave. The answer is B, right? Absolutely. Okay, next question. Okay. Answer is B only. We'll discuss about it. Basically, fiscal space is that expenditure potential is basically that we can make expenditure of, say, 20,000 rupees. And our real expenditure is, say, 16,000 rupees. So 4,000 rupees is the fiscal space. So we can spend this amount as per our requirement. So fiscal space is that we have some extra money that we can use anywhere. Okay. These are some of the facts not important for you. Now, FRBM Act. FRBM Act is basically, it was started so that there can be a control over the central government's ability to borrow the money and central governments working with respect to the fiscal deficits, right? So FRBM Act, it was enacted in 2003. It is basically a parliamentary control over the central government. So central government, in the absence of FRBM, it will not put any upper limit over the expenditure, because every central government would like to expend more and more money so that it can come back into the power. It will lead to the populist expenditure, which may not be good for the country. So to control those kind of habit, FRBM Act was introduced, where there was a upper limit put for the government. It was not mandatory, but it was recommendatory. Central government has to decide a target and it has to follow that target. Okay. So revenue deficit target, fiscal deficit target were laid down. And other things were laid down. Revenue deficit of 0%. Ki revenue deficit ma 0% hoga. Fiscal deficit 3% hoga. Contingent liability nahi hoga. Contingent liability is basically kind of guarantee. Ki central government bahut sari guarantee deti thi pehle. Wo guarantee ab nahi deti hai. Aur RBI purchases the government bond. That RBI cannot, government cannot borrow directly from the RBI. Ek tarah se ye hota tha hamara deficit financing hota tha hamara ye. तो ये अलाउड नहीं हुआ कि नाउ द आरबीआई कैन नॉट डायरेक्टली गिव लोन टू द गवर्नमेंट थ्रू द गवर्नमेंट बॉन्ड. ठीक है, बिकॉज दैट वुड मीन द डेफिसिट फाइनेंसिंग. सो बोरोइंग फ्रॉम द आरबीआई प्रायर टू द एफआरबीएम एक्ट, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट डेफिसिट वर फाइनेंस थ्रू मोनेटाइजेशन ऑफ डेफिसिट बाय आरबीआई, जिसको हम बोलते थे डेफिसिट फाइनेंसिंग. सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट वेन एवर इट नीड्स द फंड इट विल गो टू द आरबीआई, इट विल इशू द बॉन्ड टू द आरबीआई, आरबीआई विल प्रिंट द मनी एंड इट विल गो टू द आरबीआई. But this printing of the money will lead to the inflation, high amount of inflation. So in 2006, it was restricted. Central government cannot take the loan from the RBI directly. It will go to the public. And if it go to the public, then RBI do not need to print the money. Okay. So FRBM had imposed complete ban to borrow the money directly from the RBI. But it allowed temporary borrowing from the RBI to meet excess of cash disbursement and over cash receipt during any financially as per the agreed terms. Kuch exception tha chota mota, lekin primarily band kar diya tha. So NK Singh committee, basically what happened, FRBM, it was introduced in 2003 and it had the target for 2009. Ki 2009 tak hum sare fiscal deficit ko stable kar lenge. Theek hai, lekin jaise hamari zindagi mein hota hai, hum log target set karte hain ki yaar August ke end tak hum pura prelims ka syllabus complete kar lenge, GS 2-3 कंप्लीट कर लेंगे. लेकिन कभी होता है, कभी नहीं होता. टारगेट हमेशा पोस्टपोन होते रहता है. 31 अगस्त का क्या हो जाता है, 15 सितंबर का 30 सितंबर. जिंदगी ऐसे ही चलती है. तो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट का भी ऐसा ही चल रहा था. 2009 में अनफॉर्चुनेटली फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस आया, ग्लोबल फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस आया, जिसकी वजह से इंडियन गवर्नमेंट को बहुत सारा एक्सपेंडिचर करना पड़ा. इंडियन गवर्नमेंट हैड टू इन्फ्यूज द मनी इन द पब्लिक. so that the country can come over the financial crisis which started in the USA. So 2009 में सारे के सारे बजट हिल गए, उसके बाद कभी भी वो वापस से सेट नहीं हो पाए, उसके बाद वो कभी भी जो टारगेट्स थे वो पूरे नहीं हो पाए. फाइनली 2018 में एनके सिंह कमेटी को इस्टेब्लिश किया गया कि एनके सिंह कमेटी को ये टर्म्स दिया गया कि आप बताइए कि हमें किस तरह से एफआरबीएम को रिवाइज करना चाहिए. तो एनके सिंह कमेटी सेज नंबर वन, वी शुड नॉट टेक द डेफिसिट एज द एंकर. जो डेफिसिट होते हैं उसको हमें टारगेट बना के नहीं चलना है, बिकॉज डेफिसिट तो कम ज्यादा हो सकते हैं. उससे भी ज्यादा जो इंपॉर्टेंट होता है वो होता है डेट टू जीडीपी रेशियो, राइट. सो वी शुड हैव ए टारगेट टू रिड्यूस द ओवरऑल डेट, बिकॉज जो डेफिसिट है एवरी ईयर का वो कंपाइल होकर वो डेट को बढ़ाता रहेगा. तो फिस्कल डेफिसिट को भी फोकस करेंगे, लेकिन उससे भी ज्यादा जो इंपॉर्टेंट है वो है हम ओवरऑल डेट टू जीडीपी रेशियो को कंप्लीट करेंगे. सो रेदर देन मेकिंग द डेफिसिट एज अ प्राइमरी एंकर, वी विल मेक द डेट टू जीडीपी रेशियो एज द प्राइमरी एंकर. दिस वॉज द फोकस ऑफ द एनके सिंह कमेटी. दिस वॉज वन थिंग एंड सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट अडॉप्टेड दिस एंड सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट पुट ए अपर लिमिट कि सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट जो है वो 16-17 में जो 50% था ऑलमोस्ट, 22-23 में उसको हम 38% लेके आ जाएंगे, ठीक है. सो फ्रॉम ए लेवल ऑफ अप्रोक्सीमेटली 40% वी विल कम टू द अप्रोक्सीमेटली 40%. ये सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ने टारगेट फिक्स किया. सेकेंड सजेशन ऑफ द एनके सिंह कमेटी वाज कि इंस्टेड ऑफ फिक्सिंग ए पार्टिकुलर डेफिसिट वी विल फिक्स ए रेंज. हम ये ना बोल करके कि 3% ही हम लाएंगे फिस्कल डेफिसिट को, हम एक रेंज की बात करेंगे कि फिस्कल डेफिसिट शुड बी बिटवीन दिस रेंज टू दिस रेंज. ओके, सो दिस फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी वाज गिवन रादर देन ए फिक्स्ड टारगेट, वी विल गिव ए रेंज, ठीक है. तो ये सेकंड था. थर्ड कमेटी रिकमेंडेशन वाज देयर शुड बी ए इंडिपेंडेंट फिस्कल काउंसिल, राइट. सो जस्ट लाइक वी हैव ए मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी कमेटी एमपीसी नाउअडेज, देयर विल बी अ सेपरेट फिस्कल काउंसिल व्हिच विल oversee the overall target of the central government and will give the recommendation from time to time. This was the third suggestion which was not accepted. The fourth suggestion was that there should be an escape clause in any unwarranted situation, in any extraordinary situation. If the central government is not in a position to meet the target, then it can meet the target next year. So this escape clause was granted, and unfortunately, we have to use this escape clause very recently in the form of COVID, like because of the COVID. So because of the COVID lockdown, this actually forced the government to use the escape clause. Iske wajah se government ko escape clause follow karna pada, right? So we will discuss all of this. So you can see NK Singh committee recommended that there should be a overall debt to GDP ratio 60% of GDP, 40% for the central government and 20% for the state government. So central government ka jo rahega wo rahega 40% of GDP and state government ka rahega 20% of GDP, right? So is tarah se 60% of GDP hamara total target ho jayega. And this was recommended and this was accepted. So ye accept ho gaya. Fiscal deficit NK Singh committee says ki 2.5% hona chahiye. Government says ki nahi, 3% ka hum target rakhenge, isko hum kam nahi karte hain. So it was accepted but in a very partial manner. Revenue deficit NK Singh committee says ki 0.8% हम अलाउ कर सकते हैं. एफआरबीएम एक्ट सेज कि कोई टारगेट नहीं है, यानी कि कोई मतलब पहले 0% का टारगेट होता, अब कोई टारगेट है नहीं, ठीक है. तो ये एक तरह से रिजेक्ट हो गया था. फिस्कल काउंसिल इट वाज रिजेक्टेड एंड एस्केप क्लोज इट वाज एक्सेप्टेड, ठीक है. फिस्कल काउंसिल इसका कंपोजिशन बताया गया था, लेकिन आपके लिए रिलेवेंट नहीं है क्योंकि ये हमने एक्सेप्ट नहीं किया, ये कभी हमने इंप्लीमेंट नहीं किया. एस्केप क्लोज central government will have a flexibility and this in the escape clause up to 50 basis point, that is up to 0.5% can be the flexibility, okay. And for this the government can directly participate in the primary auction, that means the government can directly ask the RBI to print the money, and in return of the government bond this money can be utilized by the central government, right. What are the circumstances under which the escape clause can be followed? So number one, war. अगर इंडिया पाकिस्तान की वार हो जाए, इंडिया चाइना की वार हो जाए, कैलमिटीज ऑफ नेशनल प्रोपोर्शन, फॉर एग्जांपल कोविड,
a collapse of agricultural activity, far reaching structural reforms, कोई बहुत बड़े structural reforms आए जिसकी वजह से कोई problem हो गई, ठीक है, और sharp decline in the real output growth, that is the real GDP of at least 3 percentage point. So these are the 5 circumstances. Please take few seconds and try to remember these, because there is a possibility that they can ask the question. They can give this statement and they can ask a question. Budget 21, fiscal deficit target was kept at 9.5%, and finance minister says ki isko hum kam leke aayenge, but bharosa nahi hai abhi, halat bahut kharab chal rahi hai. You can see the trends in the deficits, fiscal deficit, this is the trend. You can see this is not steady, na to decrease ho raha hai na increase ho raha hai, theek hai, ye up and down chal raha hai, unstable hai, theek hai. Similarly, effective revenue deficit, you can see, and so answer is C only. Statement 1 is correct. Statement 2 is incorrect. Because central government and state government ka reverse ho gaya hai. These are some of the other factual things you can go through yourself. Fiscal performance. These are very easy things you can go through. Finance bill we can discuss. Please see this. Okay, so answer is A only, because the statement B is about memorandum. You know, finance bill, Article 110. It is money bill, and yeah, it deals with the tax proposals. क्या क्या टैक्स लगाने वाले हैं, क्या क्या टैक्स हटाने वाले हैं. ठीक है, व्हाट इज अप्रोप्रिएशन बिल, व्हाट इज अप्रोप्रिएशन बिल, अप्रोप्रिएशन बिल इज अबाउट द एक्सपेंडिचर पार्ट, राइट. फाइनेंस बिल इज फॉर द रेवेन्यू, द टैक्स, द टैक्सेस, राइट. या सो विद दिस वी कंप्लीट दिस पब्लिक फाइनेंस चैप्टर. And we have one more session on the taxation.